Another episode of GAMER-0, where we spread that gaming truth like a virus. I'm your host, T-Heel. So you've seen the title. Does Nintendo have a clue? So I know I'm going to get people out there, oh, you fanboy this. Okay, cool. Let me just make my case. I say this, there's a few points I want to throw out there. The Nintendo Wii, stellar success. But was it more of a flash in the pan type of thing because of the new Wii control scheme that, you know, has really allowed Nintendo to come back from two really non-critical, well, almost failures with the N64 and the GameCube. I just ate dinner. But those two consoles, back-to-back, did very poor in sales. I mean, they had some stellar games, but they were hit and miss. And you've got the Wii now that has some stellar titles, but really, the console's flooded with shovelware. And even though fanboys will say there's some stellar gems, there are. But how has the longevity of the console been? And I have to ask myself this question. Does Nintendo really have a clue? Did they get lucky with the Wii? Or did they actually catch magic and they knew that it was going to be something big? And these are questions really I want to throw out there for you guys. I have some theories to these answers. One of them would be, was it their plan from day one to only go really 5 years with the Wii? And they already knew ahead of time that they were going to come out with the Wii HD way in advance. Could it be that they are actually shrinking? Because, you know, typically a console's retail shelf life is like 6 to 10 years, but Nintendo's kind of been cutting it short. N64 came, boom. The GameCube came and they stopped supporting the N64. The Wii came and they pretty much stopped supporting the GameCube. And the lifespan seems to be getting more around the 5 year range. And so I have to ask these questions, which is Nintendo switching it up and not going for a longer lifespan and having you refresh your console every 5 years? Is that a good strategy? Does that really put them in the more innovative in the industry, or are they out to just pretty much get breaded up and sell you maybe six stellar AAA titles? I mean, you got the Super Mario Galaxies, you got the Super Mario, it's the one where you can play as like Mario, Luigi. It's more of a homage to the old school Super Mario games. You can play as like Toad. You got that one. You've got like Kirby, as Epic Yarn. You've got Yoshi. Not Yoshi, but Donkey Kong. You've got some stellar AAA titles, but there's nothing other than their first party that really has stood out with any real merit. And those are so, you got Twilight Princess, but that was also on the GameCube. It's really, you know, a select few of first party titles that have been really scarce throughout the, you know, last 4 years. Has Nintendo really had a good plan going into this generation? Are you even going to consider Project Cafe, you know, next generation, considering it is coming out while the PS3 and the 360 are out? It is only going to be slightly, from rumor and speculation, it's only going to be slightly more powerful than the PS3. And that's off of a real big rumor. They're talking about actually being more on par with the 360, and they're not really talking about going into the 8 hard drive era, they're just going into the HD era. So, you know, we're hearing stuff about like 8 gig flash memory, and you know, that's cool, it's solid state, so it's more stable and more reliable. But 8 gigs? if they're looking at maybe the compressed games, and yeah, that could do. If you don't have to do installs, and a lot of games, you know, not all games stream off disk. Most games require some kind of install of sorts. 8 gigs really isn't enough, especially not for this generation of consoles. Are they still? They say that they're going after like the hardcore. I'm not sure what the hell happened there, but is that really, you know, are they going after the hardcore? Because just because it's HD doesn't mean you're necessarily targeting the hardcore. Is it too late for Nintendo to actually go after the hardcore? And I say this, and you know, I watch a lot of the bonus rounds, I hear what Michael Packer has to say, and I agree with him that their window may have missed their window to actually release this Project Cafe, unless their controller is really innovative, which I've been hearing some stuff, and I have to argue a lot of the points behind it. But with the Project Cafe going to be playable at E3, we may be completely blown away by what's shown at E3. I can't wait to, you know, it's going to be playable, so I'll get my hands on it. But it drops next year, 2012. How much time do they have on the market before the PS4 and the Xbox 720 come to market? I'm thinking maybe a year to 2 years. 2 years is tops. Like, that's like super stellar time for them to really have their console on the market before, you know, the other guys jump in. On top of that, do they even feel the need to have to do that? Because, you know, the Xbox 360 and the PS3 already have a large library of HD titles to work off of. Whereas, you know, Project Cafe is going to pretty much be starting from scratch. And I highly doubt third-party developers are going to go back and port all their old games over. They'll probably just do ports of the 360 for future games over to Project Cafe. And is that going to give them enough push? Is that an incentive? I personally think a lot of people who owned a Wii that wanted to go into the HD gaming era have already upgraded to a 360 or a PS3. And that right there is going to hurt them with this move unless their controller is really innovative. And from what I'm hearing about the controller perspective is that it's going to have this screen, LCD screen. You're going to be able to stream it and stream your gaming from your Project Cafe to your controller. But a lot of that, which really blows my mind, is if they are going to do it, means you're going to install the game on your hard drive or your flash drive. 8 gigs already kind of really puts that in suspect that that's actually going to happen, unless they got some crazy ass new technology. On top of that, the average controller costs around $45 to $65, depending on whether you get a first party controller or you buy from a third party supplier. And what really like blows us out is you're talking about an LCD screen on there of substantial size. And for it to carry over those graphics, it's going to have to be at least on par with an NGP. So now we're talking really, really good graphics. How much is that costing? Are we talking about using it running $100 per controller? No one's going to buy into that. It's just going to be, it'd be financially unfeasible. On top of that, we're talking about, okay, is this thing going to cost about the same price as a 360? So you're looking at $200, $250. Nintendo only really has, they have their hardware and their software to make profit off of. So there's going to be a markup. So it's not going to be, there's no way they're going to sell it for more than the Wii cost, than what the Wii costs. So it's going to be $250, maybe $300. Realistically, I'm thinking whatever this console is going to come out at, it's most likely $300. And if it does have this LCD screen in your controller, you're looking at it, and that's if they can undercut it. You're looking at $300 control system and $100 a controller. That shit's expensive. It's going to get too pricey, and I don't think that's really innovative enough to warrant the purchase. And then somebody kicked to me, and they're like, well, what if you use your 3DS? What if that's your option? And I'm like, well, that's even worse because that's $250 a controller. I mean, yeah, you have it, you get one. Now you're using that, and are they going to just release that and completely, at the same time, abandon the Wii? Or are they going to just use that to target their casuals and keep that sales going on? Or is Project Cafe going to coexist and you know, that's going to be to appease the hardcore, and the Wii's going to be there to appease the casuals? I have a lot of these questions, and I don't think Nintendo really has a clue. I think they waited too long to release this Project Cafe. I'm hopeful. A lot of you guys may say, oh, you just want Sony or Microsoft. I grew up playing Nintendo and Sega. I love, you know, Nintendo brand. I've kind of fallen out with a lot of what they're doing. It doesn't mean I don't love the product. I just have a problem with a lot of the decisions. They're not actually appealing to the type of consumer that I am, the type of gamer I am. So I have to put these questions out there. Do they really have a clue? Is the Project Cafe gonna really hold its own? Because if it comes out and then 2 years later or a year later, worst case scenario for Nintendo is next year at E3, when we're talking about the launch of the Project Cafe right around the corner, and E3, that Sony and Microsoft come out saying, hey, PS4 and Xbox 720 are coming out next year. Is that just going to kill Project Cafe? Done, because it's only doing, you know, this generation graphics upgrade, and you know those consoles are going to be so much further ahead. They're going more towards the PC market, and it's going to put Nintendo right back into the situation it's going to be in. So I want to know what you guys think. I personally hope they've got some kind of magic up their sleeves, but at the same time, I have a fear that they really don't have a clue, and that the Wii was more of a fluke than a planned success, and that they're not really changing the industry with making a 5-year life cycle for shelf life for the console. And I have this nagging feeling that they're kind of scrambling to compete, because they have dropped from constantly being first place in global sales to third place in global sales on a weekly basis for some time now. It's only in the holiday seasons that they actually bump back up to first place, but that's only for a small period of time, and then it goes right back down to third place again. So I think they're actually fearful because their percentage of the market is decreasing rapidly. The PS3 and the 360 are a little bit neck and neck, and they're taking over faster and faster. And you know, last thing Nintendo wants is to end this console race in third place, but start off in first place. It's bad. It looks really, really poor when you're out the race running, and then halfway through the race you drop out. It's like, whoa, I'm gonna quit this race. I'm gonna start the next race. You didn't win the race just because you were farther ahead, and then eventually those guys pass you. You didn't win the race. You just quit the race. So I want to know what you guys think. Does Nintendo have a clue? Is Project Cafe gonna just rock our minds at E3? I want to know what you guys think. Is next year going to be the actual return of Nintendo to the hardcore? So I want to hear what you guys think. Follow me on hiphopgamershow.com. On Twitter, it's T_Hill0. Or you can game with me on PSN Learns Backup. It's T-Hill. All right, I'm out. Peace.